At almost the same time, the Crown tightened its control on Virginia. There, the cause was civil insurrection. As King Philip's War was ending on the New England frontier, Jamestown, Virginia was burned to the ground by a band of insurgents led by an unlikely revolutionary named Nathaniel Bacon. The trouble started with a frontier war between land-hungry white settlers and Indians. When Governor William Berkeley refused to send help, frontiersmen rallied behind Bacon, a rich young hotblood who had recently arrived from England. When Bacon attacked friendly and hostile Indians alike, Berkeley declared him a rebel. Bacon then marched on Jamestown, captured it, and pillaged the estates of the pro-Berkeley elite. It was civil war, only it didn't last long. By the time an English force arrived to crush the revolt, Bacon lay dead of dysentery, and his buckskin army of indentured servants, runaway slaves, and former servants had melted away. Bacon's rebellion led to tighter British control of the colony. It may also have hastened the movement toward a labor system based on black slavery. Some historians argue that Virginia planters, fearing another insurrection by former white servants, began to turn to Africa for laborers. Maybe so. But other, more important factors were moving the colony toward a system of black bondage. Planters were finding it more difficult to recruit white servants because of improving economic conditions back in England. At the same time, the price of Africans began to drop, and they became a safer investment as Virginia became a safer place, that is, a healthier place, to live. In 1650, there were only about 400 black slaves in Virginia. By 1700, Virginia had a well-developed slave system.